dual PC audio is probably the hardest part of a dual PC stream setup, but it's still not as hard as you think. In my last video, I talked about how to maintain a high refresh rate, high frame rate on a dual PC setup using an Elgato 4K 60 Pro Mark II. And if you didn't, check out the tag up over here. Otherwise, in this video, we're gonna talk about how to route all of the audio properly into your dual PC setup. Now, this is my own personal setup. This is something that I like to do. There are multiple different ways to do this, but I like to rely primarily on hardware to hear all of the audio and not use any software. So in this setup, we're gonna be primarily focusing on making sure that your streaming PC gives you everything. All of your audio will be coming from the streaming PC. So the first two pieces of hardware that we're gonna focus on are the mic and the headphones. Make sure that your headphones are plugged into the streaming PC. You will be able to hear the game audio from your gaming PC when we're done with this, I promise. Make sure that your headphones are plugged in to the streaming PC as well as your streaming microphone. Make sure that is also plugged into the streaming PC. Now the reason that I have both my headphones and my mic into my streaming PC is because I want to be able to hear my notifications, my music, Discord, the game audio, everything that's going on in the stream directly on the source that it's coming from. That is the streaming PC, because the goal of a dual PC setup is to make sure that you have as much load taken off the gaming PC as possible and put it all onto the workhorse, which is your streaming PC. So first, let's look at your headphones. It doesn't matter what kind of headphones you're using, whatever's plugged in. So if it's a USB base like the Astros or HyperX, or if it's an analog base that goes into an interface like wired headphones into a Scarlett 2i2, whatever the source of your headphones are plugged into, that's what we're gonna change your desktop audio to at the bottom right corner of the computer too. So at the bottom right corner, click on the speaker and then make sure that it's set to, for example, if you have Astros on, make sure you select Astros. For me, I have my headphones plugged into a Yamaha MG12XU mixer board. So that is going to be my source of audio. So make sure that if you have an interface like a Scarlett 2i2 or a Behringer mixer or a Yamaha mixer or any other USB mixer that your headphones plug into and then goes into your computer, make sure that the speaker at the bottom right corner of the streaming PC is set to that interface. It's also important that whatever source your desktop audio is set to, that it's also the default playback device in Windows settings. So right click on the speaker at the bottom right, then go to sound settings, then over on the right hand side, you're gonna go over to the system sound settings and then find your device in the playback settings and make sure that is set as a default device so Windows never changes it to something else. Now the next part is we're gonna focus on the microphone. Now this is the part that can get a little tricky, but if you're using a headset mic, let's say you're using Astros that have a built-in mic, all you're going to do is make sure that in that same settings that we were just in, go over to the recording tab and make sure that your headset is set to the default as your communications device. It's important to note that whatever your microphone source is coming from, so if it's a USB mic, it's set to that. If it's an interface mic like a Scarlett 2i2 or my Yamaha MG12XU mixer, that you also have that set as your default communication device. Now, not only do you have all of the desktop audio from your streaming PC going to your headphones, but you also have your main microphone being sent to OBS. This is probably the most crucial step in setting up your dual PC streaming setup, because you want all of the audio being routed directly to your headphones. So now you'll be able to hear your music, your game audio, your notifications, everything that's happening directly into your headset. So now let's open up OBS and we're gonna make sure that the desktop audio is set to the proper device as well as the microphone. So in OBS, find the little audio meter and click on the gear that says desktop audio and click properties. Then at the top, there's going to be a drop-down box, which should start as default, and make sure you change it to whatever your headphones are. And this has to match the same as the speaker source that we set at the bottom right corner of Windows. Those have to be the exact same, and this is important for a later setup purpose. Once that setting is the same as the Windows setting that we set earlier, go into the microphone mixer and then set that also to your microphone source, if it's your headset or if it's your USB mixer, the same thing that we set the default communications in the Windows settings as well. So now in OBS, you'll be able to hear your notifications and also stream will be able to hear your microphone. It's important to note that any noise that happens on the streaming PC now will be heard on stream. So if you're playing a video in the background on YouTube on another screen that stream can't see, it will be playing in OBS. So make sure you are aware of that. Now, I like to install Discord and Spotify both on my streaming PC because I like to be able to control everything from one spot as a central hub. Not only does it put everything in one spot, but it also allows me to control all of my volumes in one computer rather than trying to jump back and forth between two computers. Now, everything that you're going to be hearing happening on your streaming PC will specifically happen through the desktop audio slider. So I particularly like to make sure that my desktop audio slider is set to negative 10 dB. It makes it so it's just a little bit quieter than your microphone in OBS, and it makes sure that you are the primary focus, you are the main subject in the mix of your stream. And what's nice about this also is not only in Discord can you fine adjust anyone you're talking to in a voice chat by right clicking on their name and then sliding the audio meter up and down, but you can also adjust Spotify's volume at the bottom right corner of the desktop player. So not only have you set a certain threshold that it can no longer go above, but you've also made sure that you can now fine tune it to make sure that your music isn't too loud and that anyone else talking is not also on the same level as you, because you want to make sure that you are still the primary focus of the stream. So the next step is getting the game audio routed into your headphones. And this is the only part of the software setup that I use. Everything else that I do is strictly hardware because I don't like having any fidelity loss, but the audio monitoring feature in OBS is high quality enough that you can't notice a difference between the two, and it doesn't rely specifically on network. It's still a hardware feature of the computer. It's just live replaying what's happening from the gaming PC inside OBS. So if you didn't watch my dual PC setup, I briefly touched on this, but all you have to do is add your 4K 60 Pro or whatever capture card you're using as a source, and then at the bottom right corner where the audio meters are, click on the gear and then click on Advanced Audio Properties. Find the 4K 60 Pro or whatever capture card you're using in that new box, and then go over to Audio Monitoring, and you're going to set it to Monitor Only Mute Output. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to actively playback everything that's happening in your gaming PC through OBS. One small note is you will not be able to hear anything happening in your gaming PC if your streaming PC is turned off. So you will only ever be able to hear what's happening in the gaming PC if your streaming PC is turned on with OBS open, because of the way that the audio has been routed from the gaming PC into the streaming PC. A quick little side note, make sure that on your gaming PC, you do have the speaker at the bottom right corner of Windows set to your capture card, whatever your capture card is. I use the Elgato 4K 60 Pro Mark II, so make sure that that is set as the default communication device so that it will send all of the audio into the capture card, and then the audio monitoring feature in OBS will be able to hear everything that's going on in your headphones. So now, in theory, if you've done everything correctly, you should be able to hear all the sounds you're going to need to, from notifications to game audio to Discord chats and your music, all routed on one PC. Again, I like to do this specifically because it makes the streaming PC the workhorse, and it's like having one master hub where everything is in front of you. It's really important to make sure that everything is routed to one central work hub or workstation so that you can adjust things on the fly without having to alt tab out of your game or change anything on the gaming PC specifically, because it's really annoying when you have to change the audio of a game and then alt tab out and adjust a mixer setting and then go back into the game, and then it just takes away from the experience. It's much easier to just make sure that you have everything routed right to the streaming PC where you can adjust on that without affecting gaming on the gaming PC. One last little tip that I like to give everybody for when they're setting up their dual PC setup is make sure that you have your recordings set up somewhere on your streaming PC that you can watch back. Do a couple tests. Make sure that all of your levels sound good. Start playing the game, have some music running in the background, and have someone in Discord that you play with talking. Well, just like simulate a real stream. Make sure that everything is happening, and then go back and listen to that video that you just recorded. If you found that you were too quiet, bring yourself up. If you found that your music was too loud or Discord was too loud, bring those down. Make sure that you set your levels properly. It's important to make sure that everything is in balance, because Audio is the most important thing in a stream that will make a viewer decide whether or not they want to leave or stay. Viewers will leave just because they're struggling to make out the differences of the audio on the stream. And that's everything. As far as I know, that's how I route all of my audio, and that's everything that you need to do to make sure that you have your easy setup dual PC audio. If you have any questions, please leave a comment down below. I also stream over on Twitch, so feel free to follow me over at my Twitch channel where you can catch me live and ask me questions directly there. I have a lot more videos to come out, so if you have any more questions or any issues with any of your setups, don't forget to go follow me over there so I can help you directly. And also in the Discord, I'm pretty much available all the time. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I look back at my analytics and 90% of the people who watch my videos aren't subbed right now. So please, it's just a click. You don't have to turn the notifications on. I won't ask you to do that. And please make sure to support the channel. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.
Peach, grapes, watermelon, cherry, peach, grapes, grapes. Watermelon, cherry, peach, grapes. Watermelon.
Bananas!
Watermelon, cherry, banana! There was no banana! I don't know.